So a stick bomb is a pre-stressed structure made from popsicle sticks, where you assemble them in a way so that the geometry is using strain energy to hold the popsicle sticks together. When one of the popsicle sticks is removed, that strain energy turns into kinetic energy. There are also different stick bomb configurations that explode in different ways. The cobra weave is a chain of sticks that are interconnected, and when you release a stick, when it detonates, it actually forms a wave with wave-like properties that can be measured. That's one of the goals of this research project. Now, these stick bombs, the smaller ones, are also referred to as frame bombs, and they are a configuration of sticks that they don't react in a chain, so when they detonate, they just fly apart. The first step of my project was creating a model in finite element analysis, so I began that by creating a part, a stick part, and then assembling parts into a square bomb, actually, which is this stick bomb right here. Moving on from that, I made an A-frame stick bomb and also a star-shaped stick bomb. Once those were working relatively well, I moved on to making a cobra weave and worked to add gravity and also the ground, and then eventually started to measure the speed of wave propagation. One of the things I found out was that the way the cobra weave detonates is that rather than exploding by completely converting to kinetic energy like the A-frame, the strain energy lifts the end of the cobra weave off the ground, and then the sticks fall to the ground as it detonates forward. That's why you need gravity in the simulation, and that's also why it propagates in the form of a wave. There is going to be a different amount of strain in different parts of the stick bomb. For example, in areas along undeformed regions, there's going to be a relatively small amount of strain, where areas in highly deformed regions, such as the center here, there's going to be a relatively large amount of strain. An example of a pre-stressed structure in nature might be a bird's nest, where the sticks in a bird's nest are actually, to some extent, held together by the strain energy that's created when they're bent. Pre-stressed structures can also be found in molecular structures. But the fact that things can be related in unexpected ways, for example, you wouldn't think that a children's toy stick bombs would be so related to microstructures that exist in the world, so you would be surprised how well you can relate to dissimilar things and find something out about the world.